Hello friends, my name is Mohammad Imran. I'm a second MBA student. So in this video, we will talk about the descent of testis. This is a very important topic for anatomy exam. So if you are a first MBA student, I would recommend you to watch this video from the start to the end for better understanding. So let's start with the descent of testis. The testis develops in relation to the developing mesonephros. If you are wondering what is mesonephros, it is a primitive kidney-like structure that develops during the development of kidney. I have already made a detailed video about the development of kidney. You can watch it by clicking on the I button. Moving on, the testis develops at the level of T10 to T12. The first point that you should keep in mind is that the testis begins to descend during the second month of intrauterine life. It begins to descend during the second month of intrauterine life and reaches the iliac fossa by the third month. As the testis has reached the iliac fossa by the third month of intrauterine life, after that it would reach the deep inguinal ring, and after reaching the deep inguinal ring, it would rest at the deep inguinal ring from 4th to the 6th month of intrauterine life. You can see this image for better understanding. It would reach the deep inguinal ring by 4th month and it would rest at the deep inguinal ring from 4th to the 6th month. After that, it would transverse the inguinal canal, that means it would travel through the inguinal canal during the 7th month of intrauterine life. After traveling through the inguinal canal, it would reach the superficial inguinal ring by the 8th month of intrauterine life. As the testis has reached the superficial inguinal ring by the 8th month, after that it would reach the bottom of scrotum by the 9th month of intrauterine life, or just before the birth or after birth. So this journey of descent starts during the 2nd month of intrauterine life and ends during the 9th month of intrauterine life. So these are the four images that you would have to draw during the anatomy university exam. Starting with the 3rd month of intrauterine life, you can clearly see that the testis is connected to the base of scrotum by a structure called gubernaculum. So what is gubernaculum? It is a fibromuscular band of tissue which connects the lower pole of testis to the base of scrotum. As you can clearly see in this image that the lower pole of testis is connected to the base of scrotum by a structure called gubernaculum. And you can clearly see the peritoneum here also. During the 7th month, this peritoneum would descend downward and form processus vaginalis. So what is processus vaginalis? It is a extension of peritoneal cavity and precedes the descent of testis into scrotum, into which the testis invaginates. It means that the peritoneum would descend first, after that the testis would descend by invaginating the peritoneum, that is processus vaginalis. By the 8th month, you can see that the testis has descended further towards the scrotum, and by the 9th month you can see the formation of tunica vaginalis. It is formed because of extension of peritoneum, and you can clearly see that the processus vaginalis closes during the 9th month of intrauterine life. And what would happen to the gubernaculum? The remnants of gubernaculum would form the scrotal ligament. Now we would know the causes of descent. Why this descent occurs? There may be four probable causes. The first one are because of hormones, the male sex hormones, that is androgens and maternal gonadotropins. The second is differential growth of body wall. The third one is formation of gubernaculum. This gubernaculum may pull the testis towards the scrotum, and the remnant of gubernaculum would form the scrotal ligament. And the fourth probable cause may be because of intra-abdominal temperature and intra-abdominal pressure. Thank you for watching. Hope you like this video. Make sure you hit the like and subscribe button for more videos related to the medical field.